Good morning children. In last video we learnt about diseases. What is a disease? A disease is a condition in which our body does not able to work properly. These diseases are classified into two types: communicable diseases and non-communicable diseases. The diseases which can spread from one person to the another person is called communicable diseases. The diseases which cannot spread from one person to the another person is called non-communicable diseases. These non-communicable diseases can be prevented by taking the balanced diet. By taking the all nutrients and minerals in right amount, we can prevent these non-communicable diseases. And how we can prevent the communicable diseases? First of all, how these communicable diseases are spreading? These communicable diseases are caused by agents. Caused by agents. What are agents? Agents are the organisms which cause the disease. It includes bacteria, virus, and protozoa. Second one, host. Who is host? The organism which is the target to the germs, which is target to the agents. Means host is the organism in which agents live. Host is the organism in which agents live. And third one, environment. Environment. What is environment? Our surroundings are nothing but our environment. So environment is the external conditions which allows the spread of the disease. Environment is the external condition which allows the spread of the disease. Transmission between these three can spread the disease from one person to the another person in two ways. What are those two ways? In direct method and in indirect method. Spreading of disease are two ways. First one, direct method. And second one, indirect method. So direct method, direct way, direct spreading includes coughing, sneezing and touching. If you touch the sick person, you may get the disease. And if you take the air which contains the discharge of the sick person, you may get the disease. So direct method includes touching. By touching we can get the disease. By sneezing and coughing, through sneezing and coughing the germs enter into the air from the sick person. If you inhale that air, you may get the disease. Second method is indirect method. Third involves contaminated object. You may get the disease through contaminated objects. What are contaminated objects? The objects which are used by the sick person. It may be books, pencils, pens, bag, or TV remote, towels, spoons. These all things are the contaminated things. What are contaminated? Contaminated means it contains disease causing germs. So in indirect method, through contaminated objects we may get the disease. And second one, through contaminated food and water. If you take the contaminated food and water, you may get the diseases. And third method is vectors. What are vectors? Through vectors we can get the disease. Vectors are the organisms which carries the diseases, which contains the germs, but those living things, those organisms does not suffer from the disease. These are called the vectors. Just they pass the disease from one person to the another person. That type of organisms are called vectors. Vectors carry the diseases, but they does not get any effect from the disease. So what are those vectors? Mainly insects. Mosquitoes and cockroaches can spread the disease from one person to the others. These are the two ways how we are getting the diseases. So first one, direct, and by indirect method. So how we can prevent these diseases? How we can prevent these communicable diseases? So first of all, what is meant by prevention? Prevention action means action of stopping something from happening. What is prevention? Action of stopping something from happening. So if we stop any action before happening to it is called prevention. So one bold phrase is there, one bold proverb is there, prevention is better than the cure. Nowadays we are staying at home, we are maintaining the social distance, and we are wearing masks when we go outside, and we are taking bath if we come to home from outside. So why we are following this all? To prevent the corona disease. To prevent the spreading of corona disease, we are following these all preventing methods. So we must follow the some preventing methods to stop the spreading of the communicable diseases. What are those? Those methods includes, first one, hygiene, and second one, vaccination. So first one, what is hygiene? What is meant by hygiene? Keeping our body and our surroundings clean is called hygiene. It includes personal hygiene as well as surroundings hygiene. In personal hygiene, what rules we must follow? First of all, we must wash our hands before and after eating. We must wash our hands before and after eating with soap to prevent the spread of the diseases. If you do not wash your hands, you may get the so many diseases. Why? Because if we hold any object or if you shake hand to any others, germs can enter into our body if you do not wash your hands. So before eating, we must wash our hands thoroughly with soap. And next one, we must cover our mouth while coughing and sneezing. While coughing and sneezing, if any person is suffering from disease, the disease causing germs present in the sick person may come out. So these mixes with the air, these released into the air, and if any healthy person inhale that air, he may get the disease. So while coughing and sneezing, we must cover our mouth with handkerchief. We must wear slippers when we go outside. Why? Because in the soil or on the road, there are billions of microbes are there. They can easily enter into our body through the cuts or through the skin between the toes. So when we go outside, we must wear slippers. We must cut our fingernails and toenails time to time. And we must use some disinfectants. Germs of certain diseases can stay on the articles used by the sick person, like spoons, books, bag, tables, like that. So we must disinfect those all articles, or we must boil those articles to kill the germs present on it. The floors and the walls must be sprayed with the disinfectant. And the children who is suffering from the disease, they must stay away from the school till they recover fully. So if we follow these rules, we can prevent the spreading of the disease. And surroundings clean, surroundings hygiene. To stay healthy, we must keep our surroundings clean. What are our surroundings? Our house and our school, our neighborhood and our street are our surroundings. These all comes under surroundings. To stay healthy, we must keep our surroundings clean. Some members make these surroundings dirty by throwing the garbage on the road and by letting the sewage onto the roads, which makes our surroundings very dirty, and these makes our surroundings to become as a breeding ground for insects. Mosquitoes are flies. What is meant by breeding ground? Breeding ground is a place which favors the growth of the mosquitoes and flies. So these mosquitoes cause the dangerous diseases like dengue and malaria. To prevent these diseases, we must follow some simple rules. We should not throw the garbage on the road. We must use the dustbins. Using of the dustbin is a good habit. And that too, we must cover the dustbin. If you do not cover the dustbin, our dustbin also becomes as a breeding ground for mosquitoes and flies. So the dustbin should be covered and must not leave the sewage onto the roads. And we should not spit on the road. A Apart from this, we must follow some more rules to prevent the diseases. So what are those? Fresh air and sunlight are the natural disinfectants. What are the natural disinfectants? Fresh air and sunlight are the natural disinfectants. And clothes and linings and articles should be exposed to the sunlight time to time to kill the germs present on it. And we must drink the clean water or fresh water. We must boil the water before using it. So we must boil the water for 10 to 15 minutes, which kills the bacteria or microbes present in the water. Chlorination is the way of purifying water in huge quantities. What is chlorination? They add small amount of chlorine to the water, which kills the germs present in it. So adding of this chlorine to the water to kill the germs in it is called chlorination. And we must keep our kitchens and bathrooms very clean. The floors of kitchen and bathroom should be dry. To stop the breeding of mosquitoes, we must not allow the water to store. Mosquitoes lays eggs in the standing water, so we must not allow the standing water. If you find any standing water, must spray with the oil on the surface of the ponds. And we must use the mosquito repellents, door nets, floors must be swept every day. If you follow these all rules, we must prevent the diseases. We must prevent the spreading of the diseases. So this is about hygiene, and about vaccination we'll be discussing next video.